Hello again. Time for another video. Oh, my voice. As you saw in the last video, me and the woodsman made, that we were scouting for a place to camp. And we was planning to go to camp together. But the woodsman is sick. He's not feeling well. He hasn't been feeling well for a while, actually. He is struggling with his stomach. So he is going to see the doctor next week. So we hope he will soon be back on the channel. So I went alone to the first place that we was visiting in the last video. It's not too far from home. I can actually see my house from here on the other side of the lake. And I'm not too far from my car. I am a complete greenhorn when it comes to camping outside, especially when it's still snow. Now it's like 7 degrees plus Celsius. And they say that tonight maybe it will come down to -3 or -4. Degree Celsius. So my sleeping bag, it's good for down to -15 degrees Celsius. So I guess I will see if that's correct tonight. So hope everything is going well, that I am able to put up the hammock. I tried to set it up only one time, but it was really okay and easy and quick to set up. So hope everything will be okay now too. So I will just set camp, start a fire. After a while, make some food. Have to eat right. So, and just let's see what the night brings. I guess it will be a quiet night. Nothing very much exciting around here, but I look forward to test out this hammock. I've never been sleeping in a hammock before. This is like a flat bed hammock, not a traditional hammock. You can lie flat in it. So let's see what that looks like. I will just try to put it up. Let me see. It's in this bag here. Yeah. Very excited to see. New experience. I think I have a success. It's the second time I put up this tarp or hammock and tarp. So it looks okay, I think. So as you can see, it's a flatbed. This hammock called Haven XL Safari. So maybe I get a good sleep, maybe not. We'll see. I did one mistake now because I've been carrying stuff from the car and here, and I got warm and sweaty, of course. And that's not good. So I think maybe we'll start a fire and make some hot drink and see if we can dry up, because if I don't dry up, I will for sure get cold tonight when it goes below minus. So I'm, like I said, I'm a greenhorn at winter camping. So very excited about this. We'll see what happens. The fire has started. Oh, that's nice. So I cheated with the firewood. I brought firewood from home, actually, because around here, if the snow was gone, I am sure I would find a lot of firewood lying around. But we cannot start chopping down healthy trees to make a fire. So I took firewood from home. So, like I said, I'm not too far from the car, but it was heavy to carry this big bag of firewood down there in the snow. But now I can rest. The hammock is over there in the trees, and I have the firewood a bit away from the hammock so it don't get smoked. Oh, so I guess it will be a nice sunset here, I guess. But we still have like 5 hours left with daylight, I think. Now the time is around 5 p.m. and I think it's dark around 9:30 p.m. When the fire is going, I need to try to dry up for real so I don't start to freeze later tonight, because it will be colder when the sun sets. I was very like this skeptic about going alone without any big experience camping outside in the winter. Or it's not winter, but it sure looks like winter. It's springtime, April. It's the April 6th today. Norway is very cold, but this colder than normal. And last night actually it was snowing, so but the forecast is getting better every week. They say that the warm spring weather will come. It's on its way. So I hope they are right about that, because this winter has been long. Or I can't really complain, because I had 7 weeks in the Philippines. So I had a break in the winter, but this, it feels like we had winter for like a year. So it's getting better. I think I'm too close to the fire. Oh, the fire is coming to me. So try to boil some water. Up. Ah, I think I need a cup of coffee before I do anything else. Oh, that was very hot. So I did another mistake. I was sure I had a frying pan in my backpack. But I hadn't. I had this. So we will cook in this. That will do. So this is a marinated beef steak. Hope this will taste good. And we take all the garbage. We don't throw plastic on the fire. Look at this beef. Ah, this is nice. Ah. So we use some paprika or pepper butter. Is going to be okay. Ah. we have, I don't know if you can see these too well, but I will show you. This is the food. It tastes, it smells very good, and I think it tastes better than it looks. Yeah, I'm done eating. I made a hot blackberry drink. And I made it a bit stronger. So I bought this in the Philippines. So hello to my Philippines viewers, I know you are out there. I brought this back to Norway. And I can assure you that it tastes okay. Very good, actually. I don't know if that... I don't think that's made in the Philippines, but at least I bought it there. So I think I paid like around $5 for that bottle, maybe. $3 or $4. Very cheap. So I will have two or three of this and then just chill by the fire. This is the first alcohol I drink after I came home from the Philippines. I'm not a heavy drinker. I was before drinking almost every weekend and out party, but that time is past. So, but when you sit on a fire, sit by the fire like this and just relaxing, I think this is allowed. Maybe it helps me sleep too. I cannot get drunk because that's not very good when I'm camping outside in cold weather for the first time. But two or three of this, I think it's okay. I really hope you will like these videos from the camping. I know I said last year that I was going to do that last summer and ended up doing nothing. Like I said in an earlier video, that last year, last summer, It was a difficult time for me with the health issues, and nothing went as planned. I was struggling. But this year it's better. I had a break, went to the Philippines. I was resting a lot there, just traveled around and relaxed. And when I got home, I start work again. So I'm back to work. We'll see how long I will be able to be at work. I hope it will be okay. So I just have to give it a try. So before, like I said, I was working and go to work in the evening and came home in the morning. But now I wake up very early morning, and I work like this early morning hours. So my work hours now is from 4:30 a.m. until 12:30 p.m. So that's sometimes I can, if I'm lucky, I can be finished at 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. So it depends. I'm driving around with a crane, a cargo truck with a crane. So it's okay. So I'm just driving close to, in the area I live, so I'm not far away. So I hope it will be okay. But it's hard work. It's physical work. Climbing up on the cargo truck, jumping down, lifting, dragging. So I get a lot of free exercise at work. So that's good, very good. And I can already feel that it helped my condition, my breath. Not so heavy, yeah. My condition is starting to get better. So I just have to continue that. And to be outside like this, this is more like mental health. Yeah, a little time check. It's soon 10 p.m. and it's getting a bit colder. So the weather app on my phone says that it's 0 degrees Celsius, but it will drop down to like 3 or 4 minus degrees Celsius. So cheers. My sleeping bag is good for minus 15. Minus 15 degrees Celsius. So I really hope that it will keep it its promise. So I think I will... That's the only firewood I got left. So I will sit by the fire until I burned up the firewood. And I'm still enjoying my hot drink. This is like a blackberries, hot water, and a tiny drop of vodka in it. It's a very nice campfire drink. So I thought I was actually a bit skeptic to go out and sleep out alone in the dark alone, But actually, this is very nice. I just hope I am able to get some sleep. So sometimes I have hard time sleeping, but I hope I will sleep like a baby in that hammock. And it's actually a very nice view from here I am sitting. And the hammock is over there. I don't think it it is smoked because I have the fire a bit away from the hammock. So I think we will be okay. I think we are okay with that. I don't mind that this fire smoky smell, but it's okay not to have it in the sleeping bag and in the hammock. So I made the fire a bit away from the hammock. Yeah. It's a bit cold draft from the north still. I get it directly in my neck, so that's why I have the hoodie up. So I'm protected. So I guess I will just finish up this firewood. And I will turn the camera back on when I try to get inside the hammock and down in the sleeping bag. That will be a challenge, but we'll make it happen. I think we are okay. So see you then.
Yeah, yeah. I'm in the hammock. Oh. You can see the frost from my breath. I hope this will not I hope it will not be too much like this condense. But it's good ventilated in both ends, so I think we will be okay. It's actually very cozy in here. And I think I will have a good sleep. This is like sleeping in a water bed. It's nice. Had a bit struggle getting in here and down in the sleeping bag, but that's part of the game. I just hope I don't need to go outside and pee later tonight. It's now 11:30 p.m. The fire is died out, and I am good and warm from the hot drinks. So I guess if nothing exciting happens tonight, I guess I will see you in the morning. We'll try to get some sleep. So we'll have the verdict tomorrow morning. Good night. Sleep good.
Oh. Good morning. 5:30 in the morning, and I can report that the hammock is actually very comfortable. It's a bit cold. It's a bit too cold. There is some condensation, but not too bad actually. But I think I need to hang it to dry. There is
a bit frost on the inside here. So I don't think I will be able to sleep anymore. So I will just get up and pack up and go home, I think. So it's a very cold morning. It's actually -7 degrees Celsius. So it was a cold night. Not too cold in the sleeping bag, but it's cold. So it's still dark outside, so I will not film so much packing. So I just grab my gear, take down the hammock and go back to the car. So I guess this is it for this video. Hope you will like it. It will be more of this to come. So until next time. See you again soon.